Morning, thanks for joining. What happened? Why did it fall?
Yeah, we had some differences in certain strategies which we felt were not in alignment, you know, for our long-term goals.
Okay, but if it was a convertible debenture, sir, the cost of money would have been next to nothing for you, right?
No, it was still, cost of money was at 17%, but anyway, that's not the issue. It is a compulsorily convertible debenture. But strategically, if you are at the beginning, you're not in, you know, certain differences, better to call it off.
But why did you pay 17% coupon for a convertible debenture?
That was what?
The going rate is less than 10%.
Yeah, this was an agreed deal on a certain basis of investment which we had done. And that is how it was structured that way. And since we found now that there are issues which, you know, going to be difficult for us in our long-term plans, we felt that we should call it off.
Okay. Mr. Vasudevan, this is the Lodha group that this deal has been called off with. What were the differences essentially, and or maybe what was the plan with them also?
With whom?
With the Lodha group, right?
Yeah. See, and those exact differences or things, I don't want to comment at this point of time. But the fact is, yes, there were things which we... So we mutually called it off.
So you have... Do they have a stake in the company, either of them? Vinca or Manan?
No.
They don't have any current stake in the company?
No, they don't have.
Okay. What is the relationship that you would share with the Lodha group going forward? Would there be still maybe a joint development that you would undertake for any of your real estate projects in Pune,
etc.? It's been a cordial call-off in that sense. And we have both mutually called it off. So it's not as if we are fighting on it. And in fact, there is promises from both sides to see how we work together in the future.
Okay.
Is there any relation between Vinca, Rozia and Manan?
No, there is no relationship.
Okay. I mean, I'm still not able to get my head around this 17%. Why would anyone raise money at 17% and give people an equity sweetener?
Yeah, it was for short term of 18 months and then it was convertible.
Okay. Yeah, but because it is convertible, all the more reason why people give a lower yield, isn't it?
Yeah. But this is what we had negotiated and finalized.
Okay.
Yeah. But now you are at a better place, isn't it, if you don't get that 17%? That would have been horribly expensive.
In a way, if you see, we had certain plans on using those funds. So we will be, in the short term, looking at opportunities otherwise to how we bridge that gap. We also had the second action be in position in terms of monetization of assets, which we were already going ahead. So that we will now, you know, put it on much faster track and get it done. And as you rightly say, yes, this will definitely be helpful in the long term.
Okay, I just want to get that picture clear, which you spoke about in terms of monetization of non-core assets. If you look at your annual report itself, you've mentioned maybe raising 100 crores by a sale of non-core assets. You've had a rights issue where you've raised money recently. And this is all possibly going into paring off debt. So currently, what is your debt levels?
Our debt level is about 250 crores. So the debt is not that high, but it is that our utilization of banking funds are fully utilized. And when we go for future jobs, we require certain margins, right? So that is why we wanted certain gaps, which
and
we are filling it up.
Non-core assets?
Non-core assets have been a long-term plan for last 2-3 years, ever since we started raising money for... by rights issue. That time also we had made this. So we have substantial non-core assets which we have got built up. And also there are certain real estate assets also where we feel now is not the time, so let us monetize and get out.
Okay. Promoters were also selling stake in Vascon, isn't it?
No.
No,
I am the promoter.
You have not been selling any stake?
Okay. Absolutely no. In fact, we will be looking at buying rather than selling.
Okay. What is the alternative source from which you're raising money now that this 110 crores will not come from us?
We were in talks with certain other people while we were doing this. So we will reactivate them, but we require very minimum. We require hardly 30-40 crores. We'll reactivate that in a manner by, again, through a debenture route or something. And then we should be back on track. There should be no strange in any long-term growth of the plan.
You will not lose any business projects because of this deal getting called off? With the Lodha Group itself?
No. See, the strategy of joining them was for something different. And on our existing strategy, which is the strength on which the company has been built for the last 30 years, there is no change in that. So that is going on as per schedule.
Okay. So can you just tell us about the real estate projects currently which you are undertaking, or how much have you sold from that?
No, we have a few real estate
projects.
You have a
land bank of around 300 acres, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah. But not all of them are ripe and ready to go off. So there are certain which are raw lands, which needs conversion. But we have about 50 acres of development in Kharadi, which we were on, where we finished the first two phases, where we have sold about 1,100 flats. And we are launching the second phase in the next 2 months' time. Because there are certain regulations need to be fulfilled. And as soon as that is ready, we have the permissions. So we will be launching those projects after taking the number and compliance, going through compliance RERA regulations, and launching those projects. And there are one or two other ongoing projects on which there are minor expansions, like a commercial project in Nagar Road, where we are getting another 50,000 square feet. These are things which are also going on. And our focus, as I said, was going to be on the affordable housing sector, both for private sector as well as government sector. And we are in talks with certain government where we are in the advanced stage of closing on certain deals.
Okay. Well, actually, your profits were falling in the last few quarters. Did something go wrong?
Basically, it was as the revenues were going down, as we had stopped taking contracts in between period where we had huge losses creeping up, and we were focusing on good contracts. So we bought whatever were the old contracts, we wanted to get rid of them and then focus on new ones. That's what was we were working on, which is over. And last year onwards, we have now all contracts which we are on positive cash flow scenarios.
Okay. I don't know, Mr. Vasudevan, you are a listed stock and you are not telling your investors why you entered into a contract which looks per se so way out of whack with market yields. 17%, I'm not able to get my head around that. Your investors would want to know.
Sure. Actually, we have disclosed this and then only gone into this. All the approvals have been obtained on the basis of that. And we've given explanations.
Okay. Well, Mr. Vasudevan, I will leave it at that. Thank you very much.